The death toll in Afghanistan has reached 1,004 American soldiers. Hello, it's February 23rd, 2010. My name is Reginald. I'm also known as Dimcat. In Afghanistan, according to iCasualties.org, 54 Americans have been killed in Afghanistan this year. 1,000 overall for the whole war. In Iraq, it's been 4,378 soldiers, American soldiers, killed in Iraq. And the top general in Afghanistan, General McChrystal, apologized on Afghan TV because they had an airstrike that killed 21 innocent people. Yes, they're innocent. This is what I mean by they don't hate us because of our freedom. They hate us because we're dropping bombs on them. This is why people want to kill us, okay? And don't tell me that, oh, this is collateral damage. We didn't mean to kill them. Well, okay, if I dropped a bomb on your house and killed your daughter, would you really care if I was aiming at your brother? I mean, this is why people want to go after the U.S. government. You know? Anyway, Senator Brown of Massachusetts, the Republican, is joining four other Republicans, 55 Democrats, and two independents to push forward this small jobs creation bill. And, you know, I don't think it's really that awful. It has some highway spending, and I think infrastructure is always pretty important. That's actually something worth spending money on. It has some tax cuts. You know, I don't know a lot about it, but you guys tell me if you're against it. I don't see any reason to really jump on the Democrats for this. It's not a big waste of money. It may actually be worth something. Anyway, Republicans who voted against the stimulus package, some of them are now asking Obama for money. But two representatives from Alabama, they're Republicans, they're in the U.S. House, and one is Bonner, and another one is Outerholt. They basically voted against the stimulus package, and they asked Obama, where are the jobs? And now, I mean, well, 3 months later, what am I saying? Okay. And over the next 3 months, they basically asked Obama for money for transportation in Alabama. I mean, at least five times. They're claiming that these projects are going to create thousands of jobs. You know, I think there should be some consistency. Either you're for Obama's stimulus package or you're not. You know, if you like his ideas, then support it. Don't go against it because you're a Republican. Just stand by the things you actually represent. Personally, I thought it was a really bad idea, and the fact that the government had to make up job numbers pretty much proves that. They basically were claiming that they created jobs in districts that didn't even exist. Anyway, Citibank had to disclose to their customers that basically they reserved the right to require people to give them 7-day notice if they want to get money out of their checking account. Let me read a quote. According to BusinessInsider.com and Fox Business, and you guys let me know if this is accurate or not, because I've seen this all over the internet. You guys let me know. But these seems like pretty good sources if it's coming from some mainstream places. Effective April 1st, 2010, we reserve the right to require 7 days advance notice before permitting a withdrawal from all checking accounts. While we do not currently exercise this right, and we have not exercise it in the past, we are required by law to notify you of this change. Very interesting. Let me know what other articles you can find on this. Let's get down to the bottom of that. Okay, millions of Americans are facing years of unemployment. Basically, according to this article, roughly 2.7 million people are going to run out of unemployment insurance by the end of April, if Congress does not act. Okay, regulators report 27% jump in problem banks. This is very interesting. The number of problem banks jumped 27% in the fourth quarter, supposedly when the recession was coming to an end, right? The number for 2009 was 702, and that's the official. That's the highest number we've had since 1993, but that's just official number of banks that are really in trouble. The FDIC is claiming they managed to get a profit of $914 million for the quarter. Regulators so far have closed 20 banks this year, and they've closed 185 since January 2008. Now, we're seeing more families live in the same house. We're seeing more generations under the same roof because of the economic situation here in America. And we're seeing the decline of the standard of living here in America. Consumer confidence dropped to their confidence. The confidence index declined to 46, which is very, very low. But I never really bothered much with that index. It doesn't really mean much to me. But anyway, in January, it was 56.5, and it dropped to 46. So that's a sizable drop. Anyway, guys, thank you for watching this video. Thank you for supporting this channel. Please comment. It really helps. Please rate. That also helps the video. And guys, remember, food, water, guns, ammunition. And if you can afford it, gold and silver. And remember, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.